Hello friends. In the previous video, we learned about square numbers and their properties. In this video, we will see some examples related to it. What will be the number of zeros in the squares of these numbers? You can pause the video here and think of the answer. Are you having trouble finding the number of zeros? Let's find it together. The number 50 has 1 zero and the number 100 has 2 zeros. The number of zeros at the end of the squares will be in pairs, that is, their count will always be an even number. Therefore, there will be 2 zeros in the square of 50 and 4 zeros in the square of 100. Isn't that easy? Now, if I were to say that you have to find the perfect square from the following numbers, how would you do that? You can pause the video here and try. Let's find the solution. Here, we will first see how many of the given numbers have 2, 3, 7 and 8 in the ones place. We know that if a number has one of these digits in its units place, then that number can never be a perfect square. Hence, the numbers 53, 62 and 67 cannot be perfect squares. Now we have 50, 51 and 64 left. Can you apply properties of the squares on any of the remaining numbers? Of course. To be a perfect square, a number of zeros at the end of a number must be even. But there is only 1 zero in 50. Therefore, this number will also not be a perfect square. Let us now examine these two remaining numbers. We can write the factors of both the numbers. Here, we can see that we can only write 64 as the square of a number. So, 64 is a perfect square. These questions are given for your practice. You can pause the video here and think for the answer. The answers to these questions are given below. In this video, we saw some examples related to square numbers and their properties. In the next video, we will learn about the misconceptions and common mistakes related to them. Thank you.